Hello, everybody. Why did my windows make a noise? Don't do that. Don't make noises. Hello, everybody, and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. We are now fully caught up on the devlog videos that I was behind on, with this one being released also today, just like the recent one on covering new maps and map changes with the next major update. So I'm not going to butcher myself when it comes to, or butcher the name and myself when it comes to trying to pronounce this thing, so we'll be referring to it as simply the Jet. So the Jet is an experimental version of the famous Mirage Jet fighter, jointly developed by French and Swiss engineers to improve the aircraft's low-speed handling characteristics. Soon, this exotic variant of the Mirage will make its way to the skies in War Thunder, arriving to the game as part of the next major update, Danger Zone. So, briefly, it's an experimental version of the Mirage jet fighter, fitted with retractable canards, which improve the aircraft's handling at lower speeds. It basically is a French Mirage with cute little whiskers, which is adorable. It's also a premium. So if you wanted it, you're going to have to shell out the monies. So it's a jet fighter for France, it's a premium, and it is, of course, the sixth rank that it sits at. And here it is with its bundle pack. So you'll get the aircraft, 2,000 Eagles, 15 days of premium time, a pre-order bonus, the War Kite title, and the pre-order bonus Black Kite decal. And it is $60. So it has retractable canards, which you'll see used on the front, improved low-speed handling, excellent air-to-air arsenal, but high energy loss during maneuvers. Here's some history on the unit if you're interested. Of course, being a Mirage, it has quite the looks to it. It's a pretty aircraft. It's a nice butt shot. And those fucking pods, holy shit, they're huge. So in War Thunder, the Jet will be a new jet fighter joining the top of the French aviation tree with the release of the next major update. Further expanding the Mirage family of jet fighters available in the game, this aircraft will also offer its prospective pilots enhanced maneuverability as well as an additional rewards to faster progress through the top ranks thanks to the aircraft's premium status. At its core, the Jet represents an experimental upgrade to the Mirage 3E, a jet fighter already most familiar to seasoned French pilots. However, unlike the standard version, this experimental model possesses two distinct features which make it stand out from its close relative. The more obvious difference is the presence of a pair of retractable canards situated in the aircraft's nose. While somewhat odd-looking, no, they're cute. This additional pair of wings noticeably reduces the aircraft's takeoff distance and allow for the lower landing speed. Furthermore, they also vastly improve the aircraft's maneuverability during lower speeds, a handy upgrade for avid dogfighters among our pilots. And here we've got another shot of the aircraft. The second, less noticeable difference concerns the aircraft's engine choice. Namely, the aircraft is fitted with a more powerful SNECMA ATAR 9K50 turbojet engine, producing notably more thrust than the 9C, originally fitted to the Mirage 3E. While this upgrade doesn't directly result in the increased top speed, pilots will notice improvements in acceleration and climb rate, both being vital performance characteristics for jet fighters, especially during heated engagements. Fun fact, the aircraft's new retractable canards were often referred to as its mustaches. That is just not cute. They're whiskers. Apart from the 30mm cannons that it gets, the aircraft's arsenal can be further augmented by IR-guided air-to-air missiles, unguided rockets, and air-to-ground missiles, as well as bombs of 250 to 500 kilograms caliber. I haven't slept much at all. I slept for about 2 hours. Bear with me. As a result, the aircraft retains the Mirage's high combat effectiveness and versatility, as weapon loadouts are not just powerful, but also well-suited for engaging a number of different targets during a sortie. Here we've got some screenshots with some cutie deployments, and then a nice side shot, and then a nice... Oh, there's a full-on butt shot right there. And that's coming to the game with the next major update, which has been titled Danger Zone, and is coming to the game at some point in the future, as I would presume. There's lots of other new stuff, of course, if you have not been paying attention to the news. Here are some of the other things that you can expect. For aviation, that's all that's been announced, although the teaser video did show off the new F-14, so that's most likely also going to be another piece of content. For naval forces, the Germans are getting the SMS Bayern, which is a new German dreadnought battleship. And the British are getting the HMS Hood battlecruiser. For ground forces, the Swedish are getting the PVKV-3, a further development of the PVKV tank destroyer line. And then we have three different wheeled vehicles across three different nations, including the new French VCAC, four-wheeled ATGM carrier based on an APC that is amphibious. The Italians are getting a new infantry fighting vehicle, the VBC PT-2, which has an automatic gun on it and is eight-wheeled and looks pretty dope. And then, of course, the one that I'm most excited for across most of the entire update so far is the South African G6 Rhino, which is a six-wheeled mobile artillery unit, and just I just love the design of. It looks a lot cooler than it should. So, anyways, and then of course for new locations, Ground Forces is getting a new map called Abandoned Town, Air Forces is getting a new map called Southeastern City, and the recently added Sun City map is getting some sort of updates and improvements. Anyways, guys, that's gonna bring this one to an end. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Goodbye.